Next, we are having some other formulas. First, we will discuss about the formula related to the sine function. Here, the sine inverse x formula related to the sine inverse x. First formulation, sine inverse x plus minus sine inverse y. First, we will consider only the sine inverse x plus sine inverse y. Is it to be equal to the sine inverse x under root 1 minus y square plus y under root 1 minus x square? If we are using the negative sign here, then the negative sign is also to be in the RHS side. To prove it, we are just to be started again same y formulations. If we are having the functions in terms of the sine inverse x plus sine inverse y, these variables, it is to be equated by the theta, it is to be the equated by the theta 2. It means theta 1, theta 2, yahan se x ki value kitni milegi in terms of the sine theta 1, and y ki value kya milegi in terms of the sine theta 2. With the help of these x and y, we can easily able to get the cos theta 1 and the cos theta 2. As per the earlier formulations, cos theta ke liye aapke paas dekhiye formulations kya tha. If you are having the sine inverse x, cos inverse 1 up under root 1 minus x square. Then if you are having the formulations here, the cos theta 1, it is to be equal to under root 1 minus x square, and the cos theta 2 is it to be equal to under root 1 minus y square. So yahan se aapko sin theta 1 cos theta 1 cos sin theta 2 cos theta 2 mil gaya. Next, we will just to be started with the basic formulations. If you are having the formulations sin theta 1 plus sin theta 2, as per the formulation sin a plus b, it is to be equated by sin theta 1 cos theta 2 plus sin theta 2 cos theta 1, and the values of the sin theta 1, it is to be equal to x, and the value of the cos theta 1, cos theta 2, it is to be the under root 1 minus y square, plus the value of the sin theta 2, it to be y, and the value of the cos theta 1, under root 1 minus x square. Now the theta 1 plus theta 2 is equal to, it is the sin inverse these functions, and the theta 1 plus theta 2, theta 1 in terms of the sine inverse x plus sine inverse y, that's why the formulation sine inverse x plus sine inverse y, it is to be equal to the sine inverse x under root 1 minus y square plus y under root 1 minus x square. If we are having the minus formulations, then in place of this formula, we are just to be using the sine theta 1 minus sine theta 2 formula. So, yahan pe formula kya hoga? Sine theta 1 cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1 sine theta 2, and we can simply derive in the same formulations. Next, the second formula is to be 2 sine inverse x equal to sine inverse 2x under root 1 minus x square. These formulas, yahan pe aapko derivation koi nahi puchega. These formulas are directly to be used into the questions. Jab apan question solve karenge, to apan inko directly use karenge. That's why the most important thing is to be remembers these formulas. Then this formula, how to derive this formula? We are having the basic formulation sin 2 theta. The formula of the sin 2 theta is to be in terms of the 2 sin theta cos theta. In place of the cos theta, we are just to be using, in place of sin theta, we are using the x, and in place of the cos theta, under root 1 minus x square. It means 2 into x into under root 1 minus x square. The same formulation, now the sin is to be transposes, and we are getting out the sin inverse 2x under root 1 minus x square. And the theta, value of the theta is to be in terms of the sine inverse x. Next, the 3 sine inverse x is equal to the sine inverse 3x minus 4x cube. It is again derived with the same formulation. If we are having the formula of the sine 3 theta, sine 3 theta ka formula kya hota hai? 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. We are simply using in place of sine theta x, in place of sine cube theta, we are using x. It means 3x minus 4x cube. Sine ko idhar layenge, it is to be the sine inverse 3x minus 4x cube. And in place of the 3 is to be same, and the theta is to be in terms of the sine inverse x. These are the formulas related to the sine inverse. Next, the formulas related to the cos inverse. The same formulations, cos inverse x plus cos inverse y is to be equal to the cos inverse xy plus minus, sorry, minus under root 1 minus x square, under root 1 minus x y square. Under root 1 minus x square, under root minus 1 minus y square. Again, to derive these formulas, we are just to be using the same formulations. Yahan par bhi apan y same formulations use karenge. Cos inverse x plus cos inverse y, it is to be equated by the theta, it is to be equated by the theta 2. Isko theta 1 maan liya, isko theta 2 maan liya. Again, the values of x is equal to cos theta 1, value of y is equal to cos theta 2. Then again, the value of the sine, here the sine theta 1 equal to under root 1 minus x square. Here the sine theta 2 is equal to under root 1 minus y square. Again, we are just to be using the formulations of the cos theta 1 plus a cos theta 2. And as per the formulations, cos theta 1 plus cos theta 2 is equal to cos theta 1 cos theta 2 minus sin theta 1 sin theta 2. And the cos theta 1 ki value aapke paas kitni hai? It is to be x. And the cos theta 2 y, it means xy minus under root 1 minus x square under root 1 minus y square. Again, cos ko idhar laenge and we are getting out the cos inverse xy minus under root 1 minus x square under root 1 minus y square. And if here the plus, yadi yahan pe plus hoga to yahan minus hoga. If here the cos inverse x minus cos inverse y, then our resultant is to be in terms of the plus. Plus ka minus hoga, minus ka plus hoga cos mein, because the cos theta 1 plus cos theta 2 is to be in terms of the cos theta 1 cos theta 2 minus sin theta 1 sin theta 2. If we are considering the cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2, then our formulations are to be cos theta 1 cos theta 2 plus sin theta 1 sin theta 2. Next, the formulations for the 2 cos inverse x, it is to be equated by the cos inverse 2 x square minus 1. The same formulation cos 2 theta, it is to be written down in terms of the cos square theta minus sin square theta, and the sin square theta is to be written down in terms of the 1 minus cos square theta. That's why we are getting out the 2 cos square theta minus 1, and the cos theta is to be equated by the x. That's why it is to be the 2 x square minus 1. Cos ko idhar laenge, we are getting out the cos inverse 2 x square minus 1. 2 is same in place of theta, cos inverse x. Next, the formulations 3 cos inverse x is to be equal to cos inverse 4x cube minus 3x. It means, yadi aapko cos 3 theta ka formula remember hai, to we can easily derive this. Basic trigonometry formulas are to be important. Yadi ye dhyan hai, to apan in sabko derive kar sakte hain. The formula of the cos 3 theta is to be equal to 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. Cos theta is to be equal to x. It means 4x cube minus 3x. And again, cos ko idhar laenge, it is to be cos inverse 3 same, in place of theta we are using the cos inverse x. The same formulations, next the same formulations are to be related to the 10. Here we are having the formulas related to the 10 inverse. 10 inverse related formula. First, 10 inverse x plus minus plus 10 inverse y, it is to be equated by the 10 inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. If yahan pe plus hoga, to plus and minus, here the minus, then it is to be the minus plus. Formulations, again the same formulations yahan par hoga. If we are just trying to derive it, we are using the same formulations in terms of the 10 inverse x plus 10 inverse y. It is to be equated by the theta 1, it is to be equated by the theta 2. Then again, x is equal to the 10 theta 1 and y is to be equal to the 10 theta 2. Then, as per the formulations, we are just to be using the formula 10 theta 1 plus theta 2, and the formula 10 a plus b is to be the 10 a 10 theta 1 plus 10 theta 2 upon 1 minus 10 theta 1 10 theta 2. 10 theta 1 is equal to x plus y upon 1 minus a xy. Then 10 is to be making out the transpose, and we are getting out the 10 inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. If we are considering the minus here, then the plus minus is minus plus is to be there. यदि यहाँ पे plus होगा तो यहाँ पे plus minus होगा, यदि यहाँ पे minus होगा तो इधर आपके पास minus plus की form में होगा. The next formulas, if you are having the three variables 10 inverse x plus 10 inverse y plus 10 inverse z, then we are having the same formulations 10 inverse x plus y plus z minus x y z upon 1 minus x y minus y z minus z x. This formula is to be important for the exam point of view. कई बार जो directly questions आता है वो इस formula पे based questions आता है, और वो भी 10 inverse का 3 variable वाला. That's why be remember about it. इसको यदि आपको solve करना हो तो we can just simply using the formula 10 inverse x plus 10 inverse y, first in dono ko solve kar lenge, then this resultant is to be again the 10 inverse x plus y upon 1 minus x y plus 10 inverse z. Again 10 inverse x plus y ka formula lagayenge and we are able to get these formulations. Next, the 2 10 inverse x it is to be in terms of the tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square. Again, the same formulation, tan inverse 2 tan 2 theta is to be equal to the 2 tan theta upon 1 minus tan square theta. Tan theta kitna aapke paas x hai, it means it is to be the 2x upon 1 minus x square. Tan ko idhar lainge, tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square, 2 same in place.